Bobby, I am so excited to ask you this question because I think that anytime we're having dinner conversations with people, we kind of tend to not really know the exact definition. So I want to hear from you, the expert, you know, how there are so many stories about genetically modified foods and what they are. Can you tell us really what it means and the history of how long humans have been doing this? Mostly because I want to brag about something next time I have lunch.
Sure, no problem. Well, first of all, it's great to talk with you today. I'm going to maybe broaden it out to talk about genetic engineering in general. So that's going to be a little bit broader than just genetically modified. So there's really, I'd say, three main ways that you can, you know, modify or engineer a crop. There's what's called traditional breeding. And that's usually the result of that's taking a wild crop that existed usually thousands of years ago, domesticating it, and then selectively breeding, crossing, selecting progeny. So it's really about that breeding and just progressively making new and improved varieties. So that's sort of breeding, that approach to engineering. In the last about, you know, 30 or so years, it's really come on what we call GMO. So it's genetically modified organisms. And so that's a way of modifying where you will introduce a new gene and a new trait, usually taking a gene that's not found in that species and introducing it into the crop. So that's GMO. And then the third sort of approach to engineering, which is a newer, more modern technique, it's called genome editing or gene editing. And that's where you can really go in and make specific changes to the genes that exist within the crop. So when I really think about engineering, I think of those three approaches: breeding, GMOs, and editing.